Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to Farming Simulator 17. We're on our Goldcrest Valley map, and you see that face right there? Right in there? That's as close as I can zoom in. That is the face of a farmer that has just won $1 million lotto. At least that's the way I'm looking at it. So we've got some money to spend, and we've got to figure out what our priorities are. So let's pop out of there and walk over to the store. We are their most valued customer today. Any sales going on? No. Okay. It'd be great to wait for a sale and spend it there, but what do we want to do? We may not do it all today, but we can certainly talk about long term. Pulling that plow 2 meters wide at a time is really frustrating. I would love to get up to something bigger. This guy, I don't remember if it comes across as a V or as a great big diagonal. I think this guy goes diagonal. And it surprised me how narrow it felt when it opened up. There's a lot of equipment there that doesn't open up into very much. It does claim to go almost 20 feet. This guy, 4.9 meters. So 5 times 3, about 15 feet wide. Takes 240 horsepower, though. That's a lot. This one here is not much bigger than what we've got. May as well not even spend the money. $22,000 to get 3 feet more per pass. This would at least more than double it, because we are dealing with 2 meters right now, so we get to 4.9 meters. So that's a possibility that we need to a tractor that can handle 240. Right now, our top is 145. So keep that one in mind. So we're 60,000 into that guy if we want to do it. Let's look at cultivators. How big of a tractor do we need to run a reasonable cultivator? Yeah, the plow was 4.9 meters. There's 4 meters. There's 4.8 meters. That opens up. Both these halves fold down. And quite the machine to watch. If we go beyond that, we get into this guy, the Amazon, which also does some fertilizing. Though I'm seeing slurry here. So I'm not real sure how that works. Unless there's a slurry wagon that attaches to the back end. It's saying the Zunehammer SKE. What is that? Slurry wagon Zunehammer SKE. So this guy will mount to the back of it. Uh-huh. Okay, so we don't really have access to that right now, so that's probably not where we're going. So this guy is probably the most reasonable. There's 23,000, requires 205 horsepower. So 240 and 245, we were 60,000 and 23, so we're 83, was it 82,000? I think it was a 59. So 82,000 so far if we go that route. What are we going to pull it with? We right now are the case. Where are we? Oh, we're bigger than this. We've got a really good tractor right now. The case 1445. It's, you know, 1/4 of the way up the list. 145 horsepower. We need to get into the low 200s at least. The Voltra is only 145 also. Let's zip forward some more. The Fendt over here, the 700, is only 165. This Voltra T-Series, here we go, 210. So we're starting to get there. Let's look at this group here. So that's the 210, 224. So these guys are the same. The 224, 224, that's probably closer to what we're wanting. You can go from here to the engine and get a boost, so that 224 just became a 245, 263. Okay, so we have different engine sizes that we can buy with these. Design, Warrior design, Standard design. I don't know what that means, and unfortunately we don't get pictures. So that was this one, right? Yeah. So if we went down a notch, could we get to 240 from these guys? 250 a day, 260 a day, 270, 270. 190. I saw this one earlier, and I'm curious why we dropped down so far per day. He does the same as these guys. Doesn't carry as much fuel. And doesn't go quite as fast. But he has just as much horsepower. So he's geared lower. He can handle more load, just doesn't have the top-end gears. Costs a little more. 192... And we can kick the engine up all the way to 270. So there's a 245. So we're at 202 with this guy, front loader attachment, and probably wheel weight. So we're at 204 to go this route to get us to 245. That would pull that plow and do basically anything else we can imagine. There are very few implements out there that will not that take more than 245. So there's that one. What does the Lamborghini offer us? 245, wheel weights, front loader. Almost the same price. Now a little bit cheaper. Goes faster, holds more fuel, but costs $100 more a day. So it costs $700 more a week. Let's put it that way. I think we're only on day two. So we can accomplish an awful lot in a week in this game. At the rate that we're going, at least. So that's interesting. Didn't realize Lamborghini made tractors. The Deutsch Fahr. Let's see what we have here. So can we get up to the 245 range? We can. And later, for another $9,000, we can kick it up to the next range. So if we went that route, put in the front loader. Now, the front loader is not costing us... No, it's only costing us the 800. Apparently because we own that mechanic shop, and so it's tossing out the mechanic fee. We'll set up, we'll go with weights and design. This is the Warrior or not. We don't know what that means. When we get rich, we can add the $10,000 Warrior package, and it will show us what that is. So we're on 197, 291 a day, got our 245 horsepower, the most fuel, and the fastest speed. So this might be the answer. The other one was here. Now, okay, these are the 210s. We had two more here, 210s. So what can the 210s do? Engine set up to 240 and to 280, so we can't get there. There's 240. Wheel weights. Other choices are wide tires, narrow tires. Some of them have double or twin narrow tires. So if we go with wheel weights to grip the ground a little bit better for pulling things like the plow. Heck, I wonder if an undersized tractor, let's say a 230 with wheel weights, would do a 240 implement fine. Anyways, add that and that. We're at 189 now, accomplishing basically the same thing. $10 less a day, only 31 miles an hour instead of 37. Anyway, one more option up in this category. That's the Voltra T-Series. Let's see what this guy can do. Ooh, we get colors. The other ones have colors? I didn't notice. I don't think so. I think it would have started at white and it would have surprised me. So there, engine to 250. Okay, and wheel weights. So 192, that's close to what the other one was. No, the other was 189, so we're a little bit more. A little more horsepower. A little more per day. Not as fast and less fuel. But we can make it any color that we want. a deep green. And rim color... probably some kind of a gray. So, 194. That is it. I don't really want to go this route. Well, we'll peek at it. What are we capable of? Engine can go to 230, only to 230. Wheel weights and color. Okay. That feels more like a piece of construction equipment to me. Than a farm tractor, so I'm going to pass on that guy, just from the feeling, the looks of it. So really, we're in here, and I think we're here. Well, that's the Massey Ferguson. That's the one that was $189 for the whole package. It'll do the job. It's a good name. Lots of mirrors. What if that guy's off to the side so you can see past it? I think it is. You know, let's do it. Buy it, $189? Yes. So there's our next tractor. And back, let's go check that out. Okay, there's your way in. Here's your fuel tank. Oh, those are not mirrors, those are lights. Okay, lots of lights. Wow. There's the wheel weights. There's the mount for the front loader. And exhaust is off to the side. Lots of curved windows. And a window down the back to kind of see your hitch. No, not really. It's behind the seat. But, yeah, you can't really see the hitch down there. You just gotta wing it. Ooh, it's a nice sound. But you're pulling a load, this one would be quite throaty. Good sound to it. Lots of little warning stickers all over. No baby on board. Read the instructions. What is that symbol there? Or it's a sticker there. I must tell you how to run the controls down here. That's interesting. Right there at the 6, 7, 8. It's like you put your palm, it's almost like a mouse. Put your palm on the big thing and you get your fingers there. Maybe not, but that's what it looks that way though. Looks like you just rest your hand on it and use the controls. Okay. Oh, that was interesting. Fire that up again. Lots of little noises afterward. Boy, I like it. Got me a new car. All the different, I'm thinking hydraulic connections and... Yeah, good stuff in there. Okay, back over here. So, yeah, I would say the cultivator is a must. And I'm thinking this guy. So let's hook that guy up. Double click, no options. The Tirano 5FM Horsch. Buy, yes. And the plow. That's the one we signed up for. That's what we got the 240 horsepower for. So let's do it. No options. Buy. Okay. So we've just spent $250,000. Something like that. No, more like a quarter. Yeah. So, where next? We want some tippers. We've got an 8,000 capacity right now, $5 a day, one in our garage. Connects to both of these guys, the 8041 and the 1600. 8,000, 8,500, so not much difference, other than this is a dolly front, or dolly front end here, which takes a bit of practice to be able to back them up. This guy is a fixed trailer, in the sense that you've got your long trailer hitch out here, and your wheels are at the back, so it backs up like a more, what you would more expect to be a typical trailer. This guy, same thing, except double axle. So this will be fairly easy to back up, and just about double the capacity of what we've got now. Same cost per day. I'm thinking that's the one right there. Eventually, I would like three. Right now, I would say one is enough. And let's go ahead and get that one bought. Wheel setup. Okay, wide tires are standard. We'll go with standard. Buy. Purchase, yes. Okay. So we've got another trailer. We've got a decent plow and cultivator. Will we keep the other ones? I don't know. Eventually, we'll probably duplicate these so we can have multiple of these running in multiple fields simultaneously. But it'd be nice to not pay labor to run a thin plow twice as many times through the field. So that's why that. Sower. We've got this guy. And he does a very good job. 3 meters width. That's the one I'm used to right there. 3 meters width from Farming Simulator 15 and maybe 13. What would I like to get? Probably getting in closer to this guy. Offers seed directly, no previously cultivated or plowing necessary. Ooh. Did we just buy a cultivator we didn't need? So this guy would seed it, or cultivate it, and seed it, and fertilize it all in one step. Yeah. 52,000. He's big, though. 20 feet. Kind of difficult to get turned around in smaller fields. That's for the big fields. That's probably equipment that would sit around field 5 or down in the southwest corner of the map, those bigger fields down there where we were doing all those sugar beets at one time, and just leave it down there in the big fields and have one of these guys or something for our smaller ones around the existing farm. You are potatoes. You are... So what is sugar beets? That's potato. Right? So does that mean liquid fertilizer and dry fertilizer? I'm not sure. I'm not seeing a symbol that looks like sugar beets in here anywhere. Got the typical six there. Corn, sunflower, and for some reason soy. Now is that sugar beet there? Okay. I was thinking that was the oilseed radish, but that's sugar beet there. All right. So there may be a couple others that had that symbol too. All right. So I think for now, we will stick to what we've got. So that is sugar beet there. Yeah, that's potato. So we got that guy. He fertilizes for us. I think we're going to call that one good. What else is in here that's of any kind of importance? I'm not... Eventually a harvester, something bigger than what we've got. But we don't have a field big enough yet to worry about that. So I don't think we're going to go to that expense. These guys are expensive. Time you get up a little higher to something that can handle most anything. Oh, you're into the $250,000 range, quarter to a third. It doesn't make sense to go from here to just here. You know, we may as well take several steps up. So I think we'll wait on that one. That still leaves us over 700,000 to do things with. And we want to be able to do some other things. You know, mowers. That's right. These tractors needed what? We picked up one of these, right? Yeah. So this needs 70 and 160. What I don't know is if that's a cumulative. If you hook them both up, does it need 230? I'm thinking it does. So if we had gone this route, we would have needed 90 and 170, so 260. So we probably would still not have been able to do it. But we can get these guys on and do some serious mowing picking up grass and doing some silage soon. So this guy's probably going to be in a future episode. But we don't need that right now. But logging equipment would be kind of nice to get a hold of soon. Baling equipment. Boy, it'd be nice to get the square bales going. Forestry. It'd be nice to get the big trailer. And maybe a wood chipper, though they don't sell for very much, the wood chips. So that's kind of a waste. And I don't know if we're... We may eventually get into these guys just to play with it. But I'm thinking a trailer like this would be a good thing to do. Telehandlers. There's something that's... Something I haven't spent a lot of time with, but I've been watching other Let's Plays, and they're having a lot of fun with them. Where are those? What does that look like? Wheel loader. That's not the same thing, right? No. Back. Is it at the beginning? Tractors, harvesters. Okay, let's go toward the back end. There. All right, so the differences in these guys. That looks like a road grader to me. That looks like construction equipment. So the JVC, we have just the three choices. Fourth one's over here. That's a mod that I put in. So I've gone through the mods at the beginning of the game and tossed in a bunch of the different pieces of equipment that Giant has allowed to be directly connected to the game. So to me, it's just like almost like a DLC. It's just something that's been added to the game. But these guys right here. This guy, 112, 107, prices are basically the same. What's the differences? 145, 141, and 222 horsepower. Cost per day is almost the same. Speed is the same. All right, so if we were to go, we'll start here. No upgrades available. Back, no upgrades. It's not even a different engine size. Okay, so what you've got, you've got. Got the Manitou, we've got the JCB. Just wondering, I think we're in one of these two. And I don't really want... Do I want the road grader look? Or do I want... What does that remind me of? Like a Kubota tractor and its curves and whatnot. I wonder if a Kubota is going to be a mod soon for 2017. I know I've seen them in 2013, and I'm sure they were in 2015. Different mods you can get. There's all kinds of equipment that folks will make for this game that you'll be able to drive around in. Sports cars, you name it. I'm kind of liking this guy. I've never used it before. So if we got this, we would have access to basically front loader sort of things, but in an environment that isn't a tractor. So we've got the telehandle that will extend out right here. So it'll get longer, go out and grab stuff and bring it back to you. And this guy, let's see here. 4,500. There's our capacity on him. Versus what we've got now. This guy and that one. 18. So not quite three times, but it'll hold so much more. I like that. That little guy just doesn't hold a lot. So let's do that. Let's do that telehandle. That'll be our last big one for today. I like the Manitou. I don't see any reason not to. I use to stack and load various goods. So other than the tractor, it's kind of the multi-tool of the farm is what I'm gathering. So let's select that guy. No options available. And it's another 107,000. Buy that one. Yes. Okay, and let's get a couple of parts to go along with it. Probably eventually all of them. This guy does manure, does logs, does wrapped bales. Bales you want to pierce. I think you can probably carry two at a time with that guy. Pallet fork, shovel. Let's go with the shovel for now, and we'll use the pallet fork from the front loader for the moment. So, although I bet you it's a lot easier to load pallets with this thing than it is the tractor. All right, we'll come back for the other one. Yes. All right, Are we done for a while? There is 4/10 of our money. 40% of our money just got spent. And we'll spend the next many episodes using all of this. So, that's not the W. How do we get this stuff back home? There's our Manitou. That's not a zoom. All right. I'm just looking at all the little parts here. What is that guy? Looks like caps you pop off and something connects to it like hydraulics. Okay, so it's a pump in there to run the hydraulics. There's probably this... that's electrical there, so these caps are probably the same thing here. No ball joint. So, only hold trailers that have that kind of a hitch. Interesting. Whereas this one's got a ball joint, and above it maybe something similar. What direction is that? Is it horizontal or vertical? So it needs a horizontal plate with a hole. Probably goes onto that bolt right there. As well as two other ball joints. Looks like three different sizes. Okay. Oh, this is the place, just like the back of the Manitou. So they attach right there. Okay. And there's your extension arm for the three-point hitch. Okay. This guy here. Your all your cultivators and what have you. Smoothing everything back out again. All the different wheels and tines. Here's our plow. And our other tipper. And the bucket. All right, well, let's start hooking things up. Oh, it's a deep rumble. Let's see, let me get my foot pedal going. So used to just hitting the W. We want to do this. Yeah, let's look at it from the inside. Right there. So, yeah, I cannot see where that's actually hitting. But I want to know where it's hitting. Let's stop there. And not that one, but that one. Oh, I see. So he actually grabs with a three-point hitch. So the ball joint is directly centered and below this guy, almost vertically, directly below that point. Gotta memorize that stuff so that I know where I'm going when I back things up. So that point right there. Let's go forward a little bit and hook you up. Okay, so that one's ready to go. Let's pull that out of here, can I? I just noticed something. Oops, don't do that one. Do that one. E. So this guy right over here is what we'd hook up to the Manitou. That kind of a hitch. And then in real life, you'd crank this up enough to hook to it, and then you would crank that the other way and pull this leg up. And that would leave it free to drive around. This one had these two legs that swung down and locked into place to sit the tongue on. Okay, so let's grab the Manitou then. Ooh, speakers. Yeah. Radio. That's not the radio, is it? That's the radio. I'm a little disappointed. They missed a part of their fine details in this one. So that right there should control the telehandler out there, the telescopic arm, we'll say. Think space shuttle. Manitou Elite. Okay, let's get this guy going. And take him around the other side. It kind of feels like a Kubota, too. It's kind of a strange feeling to drive it. Like it... Is it off? Is it four-wheel steering? Is that what I'm feeling? C. Yeah, it's four-wheel steering. That's why I felt so different. It was spinning on the center axis rather than from the front to the back. So this guy is over here. And you cannot see it. Oh, interesting. so it's not centered to the cab. So I've got to attach outer... Oh, there's a mirror. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, let's go forward. Sight this guy in a little bit better. Theoretically, we're going to see that tongue of the trailer soon. Oh, I can't tell my distances. Yeah, we missed. Okay, so you are directly below the mirror. Alright, so forward. Turn out this way. There you are. Forward again. Oops, that way. Something like that. Interesting. Now that's quite challenging. And we're hooked up. Okay. Before I hook up, though, we'll make it happen. I need to hook up the bucket. See, we're gonna clear the bucket. Yeah. Let's take this guy all the way around the corner. Alright, so the telescope or the telescopic arm is centered. Okay. Now how do we do that? I'm gonna guess, okay, that's up and down, that's that way. So it's this one? Yeah, so it's right mouse hold. Like so. Something like that. Hook us up. So you can come down, and for transport, maybe we'll... I don't know, that's going to completely block my view, isn't it? I guess I got to stay down low. If we go straight up. And... Nope, going to have to stay down. Otherwise, I'm not going to be able to see out. Okay, but I can bring it all the way in. Alright, so that's hooked up, ready for the first trip. And that guy's hooked up. And we need to come back for the cultivator over there. Let's get this guy in. Let's take it this way. Yeah, this thing turns on a dime. Feels weird. And we can turn too steep, too. Or too sharp. If we make contact there. There's a lot of strange noises in there. It's as if I'm dragging something. I'm actually quite low for this. Is that tire off the ground? Zoom out. That tire's off the ground. It's too low for this. Interesting. And I can't haul any of the other equipment with this one. Well, we'll just have to limp our way home. Let's make it happen. There's a lot of weight. I let off the pedal and nothing happened. It just kept going the same speed. Alright, how do we turn on corners? Sharper than I'm used to, so I'm gonna have to do this one in a lot of steps. So, trying to remember, this was something like 140 horsepower. Okay. I'm not seeing any instrumentation. Oh, there we go. The needle works for the speedometer. See that rising there, the bigger one. Now, I am off to the left side of the machine in this one. I'm not centered. So that's a little different from most of the other ones that we've got. Yeah, it looked like I was on the side of the road, but I'm actually not. So that's the side there. A little bit hard to see where that wheel is. We'll get this guy situated and then go get the other ones and then figure out what our next step is for the day. Our barley. So it looks like 25, 26 is our top speed on this guy. Is that the other tipper over there? Kind of looks like it is. Let's go that way. No, it's not. But that, I think, would be a good place to store trailer-like things. Pull through and drop them off and continue on. So we'll kick that one around. And you're right near the grains to load up for a great, what do you call that? Not a great sale. A great demand? That's what it is. Pull through here, and... Did I do the right one? Gotta make sure I don't drop the bucket. That didn't work. Q. Okay, what am I doing wrong here? Back you up. And pop outside. I dropped the bucket. Ah, okay. So Q. Drop you off. That was odd. Okay. Pick you back up. There we go. Same sound. I see. And C. There we go. Let's go put this guy away, grab another tractor, and go back. Where is away? That's a good question. Do we do something like that? This guy's going to be used a lot. I kind of wonder if we want to get some more storage sheds somewhere around here. Park more things. For now, because we're kind of using... turn off the noise. Kind of using this for implements right now. This is nice to drive through. There's our other tipper. Let's park it in there. Okay. I don't think we're going to need this guy, are we? Seems like both of those were... Well, we'll put it on anyway. Actually, this is our lower horsepower. Because the better one is already over there. And the other case is where? Why am I drawing a blank? There you are. And there's already, I'm assuming that's a weight built in, so we'll go with that. You are connected, so disconnect you. And let's head back over and grab something else. Alright, kind of get a sense of this tractor. This is our case 1445 to compare to the new one we just picked up. Kind of hear the difference in the engine and see the difference in the cab. The difference would be night and day. Also notice the difference in the view. Got this exhaust stack right in front of us, and quite square and boxy. So we do have good access to down there. That's a view that I really like on some tractors. Don't get it on all of them. Let's head off to this side. Hear it pulling up the hill. It's got a kind of a nice throaty sound to it. See how the other one sounds. And we'll turn in early this time. Grab the cultivator. Wow, that didn't stop very fast. I think we've got an insurance claim to write up over there. So that is a three-point hitch attachment. Like that. And it pivots there. Oh, that's nice. Okay. So turn this guy off. and drive the other one back. Now what's left? I've got that tractor there, this one. One of these I'm going to have to teleport back to, aren't I? In fact, I guess all of them. Yeah. I am dying to see what this guy's going to do when I unfold it. Dare we? Is there room? That's interesting. So it's just a longer extension of what we've got, right? V? Like that. Interesting. Huh. Okay. V and X. Bring you back up for transport. I'm ready to go. It looks like I've got a good tight turn. I almost not full 90 degrees in there. Without it banging on wheels. Good. Should be able to get this through this little turn over here. No pedestrians in the way. No cars coming. Yep, that worked out well. An hour. It's a lot of equipment back there. Eyes on the road. That our turn already? Wow. 33 miles an hour feels so different. Okay. No, it's not. This is the background. Okay. It didn't come up super early. That's right. There's a bridge somewhere over there that I want to go explore. There? Not this trip, but I saw that while I was editing the episode where I found all of the... That was a little bit tight. Okay, I gotta keep that in mind. You know, the last episode when we found all the gold nuggets, I kept seeing this little bridge heading over the water that I didn't realize was there. So I have to go all the way out in this lane, don't I? Well, not quite that far. Hello, sign. So we'll have, I'll remember that one and go back and take a, try and find that bridge again and see where it goes. This one we'll just pull through and drop it off. Wow, speed picked up. I like the sounds of this tractor. Baling technology. Yeah, we've got to be thinking about that now. That's right, I was thinking we weren't going to get a baler because we already have the round one. There's no point in buying the square one. We don't have the round one yet. We didn't buy it yet. I'm thinking this guy is going to have to live like right over here. Do we actually fit through that? We do. We're going to straighten up in time? We will not. Okay. Alright, we'll go do it the right way. Pull through like this. Something like that. Release him. Good. And I guess just kind of park this guy for the moment. Put him right over here. Beacon's off, engine off, and let's tab over to this guy. So get a good sense of what of the difference in the two. Before we take that last one, let's look at Baylor's. Okay, in the cab. After driving that one, this does feel more like a toy than a major piece of equipment. It feels more like a little closer to the Craftsman Garden tractor. It feels older and smaller. Be a better place right there for the big plows and cultivators. I kind of like that. Let's do that instead. Oops, did I take the easy way? No, I turned this way. We'll back up a lot longer. Oh, wrong turn. Can we correct it? We can. All right, let's turn this right into there. Okay, let's not get to the edge. All right, let's do that again. Let's try this in the cab. See if I can do that. A little more like a car or a truck. Pickup, backing up a trailer. What was that? Oh, that was hit the F. I wanted that one. There we go. Something like, well, let's get the tongue in there. All right, we're just passing through the shade there. Can I straighten you out? No, we're just going to be crooked. Okay. How'd I do? Quite crooked. Better next time. All right, so yeah, that other plow will come up in here too. But for the moment, we need to tab over to the other tractor, so let's go put this guy away. Need to go pick out a baler. Okay. So that was the other case. So I cannot grab another weight to put on front. So I can't bring that home. Okay. So store baler. Right there. So we've got the round baler, which can be picked up with the, that is the wrapper. That must be the round bale wagon there. Bale collector. Okay. This guy is the square bale collector. So 70,000 for this guy and 102,000 for this one. This is the setup I like. I much prefer the rectangular bales. This is the one I can afford. There's another almost $100,000 just for these two. Oh, that kills you. And the question is, will you ever make $60,000 worth of bales to sell to make it worth paying for the equipment? Or you lease it for still a pricey tag there. $6,000 plus another $3,000 per operating hour plus another $580 per day. Yeah, now I was complaining about looking at the tractors, how the one is $100 more a day. This is automatically almost $600 a day. Bailing. Let's do it. Let's go round. I think we'll do that. So this guy, no options, requires only 70 horsepower, just tows it. It's got the same hitch that the Manitou has, so it can almost be drug along with that if the heights work out. Now, the Manitou is a real low height for the trailer hitch, so that may be something we won't be able to use that often. No other choices. It is a New Holland. Bye. All right, $563,000 left. Yeah, let's back this guy up and head over there. We wanted to get some farming in today. So maybe we'll go bail a little bit with this guy. Let's see, cab. Put this guy up in the air. That should get us home. And we'll go and do some baling real quick. That'll be the farming for the day. Most of the day was just spent buying toys. So, toys have been bought. Next thing we need to look at is some fields. We've got to look at our own fields real quick and just see where we're at, if there's anything we need to be doing. Then we'll go choose a couple of fields that we want to work the price down on. I'm thinking 11 by the sheep and 19 down the road as two obvious choices, but there might be something else that I haven't thought of. And it's got a beacon. Ooh. Well, let's go drop off the front loader. We'll see how this guy works. I'd like to maintain the ability to pull through these guys, leaving that center bay open. Let's see, this guy, pull down like so. About like that. And I'm going to come into here, and then diagonal in. Something like that. So we're going to choose G, that guy right there, and release him. That landed on me, didn't it? That's gonna leave a mess. Nope, don't scratch, don't scratch. Okay, let's pull through here. So this one makes the round bales. It's what we could afford, realistically. I have at least half that money left for land and the odd extra thing we hadn't thought of. So we've already cut the grass. You can see it's growing back quite fast. Probably the game's fastest crop would be the grass. And we brought in the tedder and turned it over. So we turned it into hay. So it's not wet grass anymore. It's actually dried grass that will bale up as hay. You can also bale grass and then wrap it and it becomes silage. But so think of fertilizer in a sense. But and then we took the windrower through and brought it back into four fairly even rows here. There's a few little spots that have been missed. We'll catch those with this guy. So this guy right here, can I do it without the engine noise? Let's see. V lowers that down. B, got to start the engine. We'll actually start the pickup head. And that starts sucking up into there. See, B. It's nice how it slows down. Yeah. Let's see how this works. Maximum speed is 10 miles and 11 miles an hour. 12. Okay. So it's saying they were picking up, I guess that is straw, or hay, loose hay. Not a symbol I was expecting to see. Beeps when you're 3/4 of the way full. Hit 4,000, you'll need to stop on your own, right there, because it's no longer picking anything up. back up a little bit. And let me look at the controls. So, how do we unload baler? Why? Push it into there. Rolls away. That's a problem. Why? Yep, there it goes. And let's go again. So why is the important key there? The rest of this up. I'll come back later and catch all the little pieces that got missed. Now this is heaped up quite high. Up a little. Why? Conveyor belt there is running to roll it out of there. And then back in. Left it sitting right over there. Okay. It's kind of nice. Alright, let's go pick this stuff up. Now, one of the first episodes, I talked about these piles having some solidness to them so that the tractor would actually lift up and to drive over them, but I didn't demonstrate it. And the reason it's so impressive to me is that it's never been in one of these games before in Farming Simulator. I always just plowed through as if it wasn't there. Let's just see this. Yeah, it lifts it all up like that. So that's something new to the game. Before, it was quite unrealistic in the way it dealt with that. So, let's see. C and B. That turns on the baler. We should see a whole bunch jump in all at once. Yeah, there's 1/4 of a bale all in that one big pile. So it does keep track of how dense it is behind us. I have no idea if we're actually making contact with all that. We're not. I'm going to do it from out here. We have less cleanup to do. Got to drive to the outside of the curves. So with a windrower, it really condenses these piles. There's 3 piles worth in that row right there. So why? Then I'll drive around and catch all the little stray pieces of piles of grass around here. Come back to probably this one last. Alright, a little bit over here. In that corner. Am I done now? No, one more over there. Is that fresh seed I just drove through? Yep. Alright, now that you're all dizzy, I think we're done. Not quite enough to finish one more bale. I have to bring the mower out and just snip off a little bit more to finish this bale. Yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. This has been Noble Rambler. And hit the like and subscribe down there if you would. And I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.